In this series, I aim to give you a quick introduction to some of the common plant families found in the UK. Learning to identify plant families is a great help in identifying individual plant species you come across. Plants are classified into families based on characteristics that they share. So, the way to identify a plant's family is to know these characteristic features. This video is a bit different to previous 5-minute families ones, because today we're looking at two families together, the Plantaginaceae, or plantain family, and the Scrophulariaceae, or figwort family. This is because of the taxonomic history and the characteristics of these two families. In the past, the Plantaginaceae was a relatively small family, and the Scrophulariaceae much larger. The species in both each had a distinctive set of physical features. However, in recent years, the use of molecular techniques that look at similarities and differences in the DNA of plants has revealed that many of the species in the Scrophulariaceae were better placed in other families. Quite a lot of them were reclassified into the Plantaginaceae. So, the Plantaginaceae now contains around 1900 species, and the Scrophulariaceae around 1880 species. Because these families were reclassified based on their DNA rather than their physical appearance, these two families have a lot of species with the same set of features. Just to make things a bit more complicated, there are a few other families that some former Scrophulariaceae species have been moved into as well, like the Orobanchaceae or broomrape family. The Plantaginaceae and Scrophulariaceae are cosmopolitan in distribution, with species from these families found across the world, with many in temperate areas. Most of these species are herbaceous or shrubby, with a few trees. There are annuals, biennials, and perennials. The Plantaginaceae and Scrophulariaceae contain many ornamental species, like Veronica, speedwells and hebes, Antirrhinum magus, snapdragons, and Penstemon, beard tongues, in the Plantaginaceae, and Buddleia, the butterfly bushes, and Nemesia in the Scrophulariaceae. Some have been used medicinally, like Digitalis, foxgloves, in the Plantaginaceae, and Verbascum thapsus, greater mullein, in the Scrophulariaceae. Mullein is also an invasive weed in some countries it has been introduced to. In the UK, species in these families are herbaceous or shrubby, and include annuals, biennials, and perennials. Wild UK Plantaginaceae include Digitalis purpurea, foxglove, Veronica, such as Veronica cumitris, the Germander speedwell, and Veronica montana, the wood speedwell, Cymbalaria murillis, ivy leaf toadflax, and Linaria vulgaris, common toadflax, and of course Plantago, the plantains, like Plantago major, greater plantain, or Plantago lanceolata, ribwort plantain. Wild Scrophulariaceae include Scrophularia nodosa, common figwort, and Verbascum thapsus. Plants in these families mostly have irregular flowers, meaning they're only symmetrical along one axis or plane. The Veronica species have flowers that are closer to being regular in shape, symmetrical in more than one plane. The Plantago species have regular flowers, but this is not easy to see as they're tiny and grow in dense spikes. The flowers have 4 or 5 fused sepals and 4 or 5 petals, also joined into a tube. The petals in many species are modified to form upper and lower lips, often with 2 lobes on the upper lip and 3 lobes on the lower lip, such as can be seen in this Linaria vulgaris. Some also have a spur on their flowers which holds nectar. The aquatic species in Hippurus and Calitrichae, mare's tail and water starworts, have no sepals or petals. The flowers have 4 or 5 stamens, and Veronica have only 2. Often there is a pair of longer stamens and a pair of shorter stamens. The ovaries of the flowers are superior and consist of 2 lobes fused together. There is 1 stigma per flower, and this is attached on top of the fused ovaries. Unlike in the Lamiaceae, where the stigma emerges from between the 4 lobes of the ovary. The flowers are mostly pollinated by insects, and they form two-celled capsule fruits. The capsules break open to disperse the seeds. The leaves in these two families vary widely, ranging from simple to compound, and entire to divided, mostly simple. In some species, they are arranged alternately on the stems, and in some, they are arranged oppositely on the stems. In Hippurus, they are whorled. Because of the variability in features between species, it's not easy to summarise identifying characters for the Plantaginaceae and Scrophulariaceae, but here goes. The flowers have 4 or 5 sepals and 4 or 5 petals, are often two-lipped, and the stamens are often in pairs of different lengths. The fruits are capsules, and the leaves vary in shape and arrangement. See if you can find these species when you're out and about. In the Plantaginaceae, Plantago lanceolata, ribwort plantain, with long, lance-shaped leaves and dense flower heads on long stems. Digitalis purpurea, foxglove, with a rosette of leaves and distinctive spikes of large, tubular magenta flowers. And Veronica comedris, Germander speedwell, with oval, toothed leaves and deep blue flowers. And in the Scrophulariaceae, Buddleia davidii, the butterfly bush, a common non-native garden escape with two-toned leaves and big spikes of purple flowers. And Verbascum thapsus, greater mullein, with a rosette of large, woolly leaves and large yellow flowers in spikes.